Janasya Krishnad Vimukhasya Daivad Adharma Silasya Sudukhitasya Anugrahayeho Charantinunam Bhutani Bhavyani Janardanasya Janasya Krishnad Vimukhasya Daivad Adharma Silasya Sudukhitasya Anugrahayeho Charantinunam Bhutani Bhavyani Janardanasya Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada told, if you like to get Krishna, if you like to come out successful in Hari Bhajan, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada told, if you like to come out successful in Hari Bhajan, then you must sell yourself unto the lotus feet of a pure devotee. If you like to come out successful in Hari Bhajan, then you must sell yourself unto the lotus feet of a pure devotee. Otherwise, there is no way. Today, our topic is in Gaudiya Bhajan. In Gaudiya Bhajan, what do you mean by Raganuga Bhajan? And in the line of Gaudiya Bhajan, Raganuga Bhajan, Raganuga Bhajan, and Madhavendra Puripath. Today's topic. For the past 6 days, 7 days, we are discussing on this point. Satsang and satsang. Though today also I can touch this point, but fix main our discussion today that in Gauriya Bhajan, what do you mean Raganuga Bhajan and Madhavendra Puri? Raganuga Bhajan and Madhavendra Puri. Actually, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada told the sloka by Madhavendra Puripad. Already I told 1 or 2 days before. Ai dindyardhanade mathuranat kadavaraka shihidayan tadalupu kadaram daita bhamanti 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 kim karomi aham. The sloka by Madhavendra Puripad. Actually, the sloka by Madhavendra Puripad, right, but it was a last time, last moment, when Madhavendra Puripad going to leave this material world, when Srila Madhavendra Puripad going to leave this world, then repeatedly he is crying and speaking this sloka. Oi din dardunadai mathuranat kadavalaka sihidan tadurup kataram daito bhramanti kim karomi aham. This sloka. Actually, in Chaitanya Charitamrita we find this sloka is originally by Radharani. It is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita. This sloka is originally by Radharani. The feeling and sloka is by Radharani. Radharani crying when Krishna gone to Mathura. She cannot resist herself, crying all day and night. Then singing this. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada told, we Raganuga Bhakta, we Rupanuga devotees, this sloka is the vital sloka in our bhajan. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada told, this is actually vital sloka in our Gauriya bhajan. We cannot leave this sloka. All gist of our Hari Bhajan, actually the deep feeling of Radharani already there in this sloka. We cannot forget Madhavendra Puripad, Sri Madhavendra Puripad. Today is the disappearance day of Srila Madhavendra Kripaji. So I can get full kippa if I discuss, if I have the chance to sing some glories, I mean Siddhanta of Madhavendra Kripaji, etc. That's why I thought I should discuss this point. But now, when I started with the sloka, with Dindyal Dhanathoi Mathura, the deep philosophy, deep feeling of Radharani. So prior to that, explaining this sloka, prior to that, I should speak what do you mean by Raganu Bhajan. In Rasamrita Sindhu, Srila Rupa Goswami Pad speaking so nicely, Ishte sarasiki ragaha paramavishtata bhavet tanmuija bhavet bhakti svatto ragat nikodita. Rupa Goswami Pad speaking, Ishte sarasiki ragaha paramavishtata bhavet tanmuija bhavet bhakti svatto ragat nikodita. What do you mean by ragatmika bhakti? In Chaitanya Charitamrita, automatically we find one nice sloka. Krishner Sabhaviki Piti Brajavasi Puti. Brajavasi Sabhaviki Puti Krishna Puti. Don't understand. In Bengali. Chaitanya Charitamrita is written. Krishner Sabhaviki Piti Brajavasi Puti. Brajavasi Sabhaviki Piti Krishna Puti. Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami writing. The Krishna feel strong affinity, I mean strong attraction for those Brajavasi. Automatic. It's an automatic factor. Those Brajavasis, they have strong love for Krishna and Krishna have strong love for Brajavasi. This is not man-made. It is not a philosophy, nothing. It's an automatic factor. It's an automatic factor. Tremendous attraction Krishna feels for Brajavasis. And those Brajavasis, they feel tremendous attraction for Krishna. That is actually secrecy of Rupanuga Bhajan. Raganuga Bhajan. Rupanuga Bhajan, more filter. I will have to go precisely, I will speak. So now, Ishte Sarasiki Ragha. Ishte Sarasiki Ragha. I was discussing some point downstairs, few minutes before. Ishte Sarasiki Ragha. Ishto means whom you are loving. Ishto. Krishna Ishto. The only object. Ishto cannot be two or three. Ishto is single in one. One and single. So for Gauriya Bhajan, those who are Gauriya devotee, what is their syllabus? Before starting any school's course, a college course, you are giving one paper in which you can find all the details of what are the subject you will have to go through. That is called syllabus. It's called syllabus. So we have one syllabus. We have one syllabus in Gauriya Bhajan. What is the syllabus? In details you can know what all are the subject matters of what you are going to get, what degree you are going to get. Huh? Huh? What is that? You know? Aradhya Bhagavan Vajasastanayasta Dhamma Vrindavanam Ramma Kachidupasana Brajavadu Vargena Jakalpita Srimad Bhagavatam Pramana Mamalam Prema Pumartham Mahano Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhur Matam Idam Tatradharanapa. That is the syllabus of Gauriya Bhajan. In this sloka, you can find all in details about what is the objective and how you can proceed, how to get everything. So Ishta means, in my whole entire heart, if you cut and do operation, you can find there is nobody except Krishna. That Krishna is also Nandanandan Krishna, not Mathuradesh Krishna. not Dwarakadish Krishna. So why Madhavendra Pripa speaking this way, why Dindyardunath Mathuranath? What is the sentiment? I can speak after. Let me clear this point faster. What is the deep feeling behind this? So first of all, you see, in syllabus we see, what do you mean by Ishta? Ishta means whom I can worship life after life. I cannot leave him. It's called Ishta. Entire heart, if you search, you can find only Krishna sitting there, nobody. No place is there for nobody. No place is there, no vacancy is there for anybody. Only Krishna, the Supreme Lord, Supreme Divinity. The only objective of tremendous attraction. Krishna is the only objective of attraction throughout this infinity universe. So now that is called Ishta. So you clear this point, Ishta. I cannot think of even, nothing, even Mathuradis Krishna, Dargadis Krishna, nothing, Narayan, nothing. Only Krishna is sitting. I have loving relations with Krishna. Though it varies, man to man, it varies. It's different thing. So Ishta Sarasakiragaha. That Ishta, for whom I am going to worship throughout my life, like Bhartapra, like Prabhu, like Sarasiki Raha, has some rasa, basic rasa is there, I told you some basic rasa is there. Now some flavor and this, that mix, then it changes. Taste and flavor. So this rasa, Ishta Sarasiki Raha. You are loving Krishna. But it is not simple love. It is not emotion. Because emotion is not devotion. Emotion is not devotion. So you see, Ishte Sarasaki Raga. Automatically you feel tremendous attraction for Krishna. And what I told just now, that Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking, that Jive Sarupa Krishna Nitya Das, I told you, that rasa is already there. But he needs that Jivatma, he cannot discover it. I cannot go to this basic point, very easy point. Like water, automatically the property of water is liquid. Liquidity is the basic property of water, and water flowing down, it's an automatic factor. This is property. And the property of fire, fire always going up, water always going down, fire, whenever you light one fire, fire always going up. What is the deep philosophy when you don't know? Deep philosophy here. Very nice. Fire going up, water going up. So it's basic property. To give light, to give heat, everything all natural property of fire, automatically. So Jiva Sarup this. Now those Brajavasis, they feel tremendous attraction for Krishna. Aradha Bhagavan Vajrajastanayastha Dhyama Vrindavana. So, first target, whom to worship, how to worship. Krishna, his total paraphernalia, total dhamma, I mean, Krishna's name, pastime, dhamma, all paraphernalia, all unique tattva. You cannot cut this Krishna tattva into pieces. You cannot cut Krishna Tattva, Bhagavat Tattva into pieces. You cannot cut Guru Tattva into pieces. It's foolishness. This is Akhanda Tattva. It cannot be divided. Unique Tattva. According to the reflection you are getting, you can feel different way. Suppose one diamond is there. and sunlight coming on diamond. You are sitting there, you are seeing Maharaj, night blue color coming from diamond. I am sitting here, I am seeing Maharaj, very nice yellow color coming from diamond. He is sitting there, he is sitting, Maharaj, no, green color coming. He is speaking fool. Our philosopher, I mean our Guru Bhargava speaking, oh, it is not lie. He is speaking the truth. I am also true. I am not speaking lie. She is not speaking lie. Understand? Krishna is like that, I mean that the example not sufficient, but to point out, to clarify this point, I am bound to speak this way. Krishna is like diamond. Those who are having this rasa, shakha rasa, they think, ah, Krishna, they get that test. Those who are servant, I mean, who are vitta, dasa ras, they feel that way. Those who are having vasala ras, they feel that way. Those who are madhura rasa, they feel that way. Even if I discuss about madhura rasa, there is difference. Madhura rasa you can find in Mathura also. Madhura rasa you can find in Dwarka also. But I am less interested about it. I am interested about Braja rasa. So overall term you can use that is called Raganuga Bhakti. I mean strong affinity for Krishna. So it's a common factor. Common factor Raganuga. After the Rupanuga Bhakti I can make a classification I can make. Naturally. So all Dasarasa Bhakti, those who are Rattak, Pattak, they, those who are Sakhyarasa, Madhumangala, Adi, Stoko Krishna, Madhumangal, Sidam, Sudam, they feel one kind of attraction. Even in Sakhyarasa, there is classification. Visramba Sakhya. Visramba, they don't think Krishna is different from me. Hey, who is you? Who is you? Huh? Who are you? Huh? You are me, Sam. Huh? But Krishna putting Govardhan on his smallest finger. This way. Those boys, they are speaking, Krishna is not so powerful. We are helping him, that's why he is successful. We are helping Krishna with stick and everything. Krishna, how Krishna? So this see, actually, they don't like to feel that Krishna is Supreme Lord. Krishna is our friend. We can fight. They don't like to feel that way, that Krishna is Supreme Lord. Oh, Supreme Lord. In Bhagavatam we can find when two team, Balaram, Krishna, they make two team. One team, they are playing among themselves, and they decide this factor, if you are defeated by me, then you will have to carry me, and take me up to that point. Krishna says, okay, very good. After they fight among themselves, they play that way, then it is written in Bhagavatam, Siddhamena Parajitaha, Krishna is defeated by Siddham. Siddhamena Parajitaha. Now Krishna is going to carry Siddham in shoulder. Come on, I am defeated. Come on my leg. They carry. And Siddham in two legs is playing game, playing music. In Krishna's chest is there. Krishna's chest here. And Siddham sitting here with leg. Very nice. Krishna become very satisfied. Raganuga Bhajan is so secret thing you cannot feel. Those who are in the way of, what is called Raganuga Bhakti and Vidhimar Bhakti, they cannot feel it. If I put question before you, when Balaram sleeping, many times it happens so. during, I mean, in Brajadam, many times it happens so. Balaram sleeping and Krishna messaging is there. Krishna messaging the leg of his elder brother, Balaram. Now if somebody put question, Krishna is serving Balaram? I said, no, Balaram is serving Krishna. How? We see Krishna is messaging. Then our Guru Bhagavad speaking, what do you mean by seva? Try to get this one, very secret point. What do you mean by seva? Seva means to seek the satisfaction to whom you are going to seva. Do seva, render some seva. You are going to render some seva of Krishna. Balaram thought, if Krishna going to message me, say, nothing wrong, he can message and get satisfaction. Because in different form, Balaram is always serving Krishna. Krishna is very happy, satisfied. Krishna is and Balaram, no difference between them. Same. So in Krishna, when Krishna messaging, giving, doing message of leg of Balaram, then actually the seva, who is getting seva? Krishna. Because satisfaction, Krishna getting satisfaction. Balaram not getting satisfaction. If at all Balaram is satisfied, then this is the main point, that Krishna is satisfied, so I am satisfied. Follow my point. When Radharani waiting for whole night and Krishna not coming, when last moment when Krishna coming, go away from me, get out, Radharani speaking. Then Krishna going like a thief. Krishna leaving. First of all praying, he is begging for pardon, no excuse. No! Go! Then when Krishna gone, then Radharani started crying. Oh, Lalita is gone, my heart gone. Just now you chide him, just now you throw him, now you are crying? That's why I told you yesterday. Ahe ribo gatihi premna sabhav kutilo bhavet. The way of love is so intricacy is there. So, I mean jigzag, like snack. When you find a snack going, this is that. You cannot understand the mood. Just now Radharani, go away. Now see this guy. This is a secret mood. You cannot understand this point. Follow me. Actually, the mood, what is the mood of Radharani? What is the feeling of Radharani? Why Radharani throw his own heart? Radharani's heart is Krishna. Radharani throwing his heart? Go away. Why? What is the mood? What is the deep feeling? The feeling working here, I mean deep feeling is that Radharani wanted to speak to Krishna, what kind of enjoyment you got last night, why you go there? I know you are suffering so much. You don't give me scope to do seva, whereas I was, whole night I am waiting to do seva for you. That is it. So you are suffering, I can see your face. So your suffering make me sorry. I can understand, I can feel your suffering, what you got last night. So I am crying. Follow. There is no trace of self-interest in this procedure of love. In this procedure of love, there is no trace of self-interest. No trace. No smell of memory. No smell of self-interest. Now I like to go back to Chaitanya Lila for one instant. Then you can understand what you mean by Raganuga Bhakti. Be careful. Because I must go back to Chaitanya Lila, otherwise I cannot give complete feeling to you. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Radharani himself. Radharani's feeling is there. So give to clarify this point, I must go to back to Chaitanya Lila one instant. One Lila. Jagadananda Pandit getting some special oil from Bangla. Jagadananda Pandit want to apply. Jagadananda wanted to use it for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because sometimes Chaitanya Mahaprabhu expressed the mood of craziness, crying, falling down. So Jagadananda, out of great affection and love, thought, if this Ayurvedic, I mean Ayurvedic oil, if I can apply, if Prabhu, I think, if I can, then maybe Mahaprabhu can feel very nice. That's why he got that oil. All the way, you see, no train, no bus, no plane, nothing, only working, so big oil, carrying all the way. Then the pot was kept with Govinda. Govinda keep this pot. There is some, what is that? There is some special oil, Ayurvedic oil. I want to apply it. I want to use it for Mahaprabhu. I mean, Mahaprabhu use it. It's nice. Then Mahaprabhu coming. Prabhu, Jagadananda get some oil for you.
Oil?
Yes. Because sometimes you are feeling bad, you see, your health is not good. Jagadananda got some oil from Bangla. It's very, it can keep your brain very cool. What do you mean? I'm sannyasi. Come on, I'm sannyasi. I have no right to use oil. Whereas Jagadananda Pandit, you want to use it for me. You want, I use it? Jagadananda want, I use it? Is it possible? So do one thing, Jagadananda, bring this oil for Bangla. So you can do it, you can give this pot of oil to Jagannath. So there is no light at that time, there is no light. So they can use Pradeep. It's good. Jagannath, his energy, so it's good. Jagannath came, Govinda telling, Prabhu was very angry, we got oil. Why? Sir, I am sannyasi, how I can use oil? Yes! Prabhu is sannyasi, how he can use oil? Give this oil pot to me. Take this oil pot, go outside. After that, before that, when Mahaprabhu came, Mahaprabhu speaking, Jagadananda, you bring some oil from Bangla, but you see, I am sannyasi, how to use it? So it is good if you can give this oil to Jagannath. They can use it for Deepa. Yes, you are sannyasi. You are sannyasi. Give this oil pot to me. Take this oil pot, go outside and throw the oil pot in front of Mahaprabhu. Breaks all oil, scattered all around. Mahaprabhu started looking at Jagadananda. Then Jagadananda, with very angry mood, go to a room, lock the room for 3 days, not opening that room. No water, no prasadam, nothing. Lock the room inside. Stay. 1 day gone, 2 days gone, Mahaprabhu appearing. Jagadananda, don't become angry with me. You see, I am sannyasi. You should not be angry with me. Last day after consecutively, 1 day, 2 days, third day, 3 days. Third day, Mahaprabhu become very angry. Mahaprabhu going to his door. Jagadananda, open the door. I love you very much. Jagadananda, open the door. I love you very much. Jagadananda, our opening. Jagadananda, I am going to take bath in sea, and after coming back, I like to take prasadam in your hand. Readily he opened the door and run. Oh, Jagadananda, Nandai Ramai, come. Prabhu like to take prasadam. For 3 days, is not fasting, you see, come on. He told me, rarely, he cooked everything. Then Mahaprabhu coming, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram. Find Jagadananda, all ready, prasadam. Mahaprabhu sees in prasadam. Jagadananda, actually you are fasting 3 days. I like to take prasadam with you together. Prabhu, first you take, I can take prasadam after. No, you actually 3 days you are fasting. Prabhu, you first take. After that, I give it. Mahaprabhu become very frightened. Again, he can do something. Then Mahaprabhu started taking prasadam. Mahaprabhu now speaking. So nice prasadam. I don't know. When you are angry, your cooking is so nice. When you are angry, then your cooking is so nice. You see? So what philosophy you get? What is the theme you get out of this incident? Because Raganuga Bhakti never think about personal interest. He is fasting, everything, it's all okay. In Raganuga Bhakti, because Jagadananda orderly Raganuga Bhakti for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Raganuga Bhakti. So he only want to give satisfaction to my Prabhu. No matter how different way he is treating me. Asrishva padartham pinashtumam adarsanad marmahatam karutuva yatha tathava vidudhatulam pato matpanana thasya saevena. That is called deep philosophy. Maybe my beloved, I mean, Prabhu can throw me. Maybe sometime he can embrace me. Maybe sometime can kiss me. All the same. Because I have no alternative. Sometime he can kick me, sometime he can embrace me, all the same. Because nobody there except my Prabhu. So, if you go through the philosophy of Chaitanya Lila, you can get the clear conception of Raganuga Bhakti. Clear conception. So, first of all, you should know, I can go to Madhavendapuri, but first I like to clarify that. Maybe it will take so many days. But still, maybe it will take so many days to clarify this point. But first of all, you should understand this point. Then what is your target? What is the, syllabus? First of all, Aradhya Bhagavan, Vajasasthanasthanayastha Dhamma Vrindavan. Vrindavan Dham, and Vrindavana Chandra, Krishna, I can worship. In my whole entire heart, if you go search, you can find all the Krishna city. Radharani clarifying this point. When in Kurukshetra, when Radharani all Sakis they went, the Surya Parag, solar eclipse, they went there to attend the function there. All Brajavasis went there. Radharani crying and speaking. What speaking Radharani? Radharani speaking, Aner Hidaya Mon, Mor Mon Vrindavan, Mone Bone Ek Kori Mani. Deep philosophy. For other people, if you search, they are thinking about something, something is there in their mind, something they are doing different. There is no symmetry. You cannot tally it. There is no straight line. They are manipulating something. They are doing something. They are thinking of it. All scattered. Radharani speaking, Aner Hidayamon. For common people, they are material people, what is there in their heart, they think about that thing. But for me, believe me, my entire heart, there is Vrindavan. Radharani speaking, He Nath, if you search my heart, you can see there is Vrindavan. Only Vrindavan is there. Actually, it is when only you can find Vrindavan and you can find yourself there in Vrindavan. Aner Hidayamon, Morman Vrindavan, Mone Bane Ek Kori Mani. Taha Tomar Charanod Doi, Jodi Kodao, Jodi Korao Udoi, Tobe Tomar Purno Kipa Mani. You can search my heart, you can find only Vrindavan is there. Vrindavan. Excellent Vrindavan Dharma. and you can find yourself there. You. And if you now, if you like to bestow full kibat on me, then now you will have to go. Instant you will have to go to Vrindavan. I like to see your lotus feet there in Vrindavan. Then I can understand that you are loving me. Tahan tomar charanodday jodi kada udoy, tabe tomar purno kipa hoy. Then I can understand you love me 100%. You will have to now, instant you will have to go to Vrindavan. Otherwise, I think. I don't like to see this place. What is this? Kurukshetra. I cannot that kind of feeling. Brajadham, that kind of feeling, nice feeling. Jamuna, Vrindavan, so nice. So nice feeling. It is not a philosophy. Those devotees, those who are devotees, they are feeling inside their heart. It is not simple philosophy. So nice thing there. So nice feeling. It is not philosophy. Believe me, it is not philosophy. I saw my Guru Maharaj feeling. Deep feeling, crying Guru Maharaj. So nice. I like to speak, I like to stop speaking. Well, whom to speak? Who is there to catch my feeling? Dheera samire jamuna tire basati bane banamali. Dheera samire jamuna tire basati bane banamali. I don't like to sing, this one, Git Govinda. So deep feeling. So nice feelings. So this is the feeling of Radharani. Anir hidaye mor, anir hidaye mon, mor mon Vrindavan, mone mone ek kori maya. What is Vrindavan? That is my heart. What is Vrindavan? That is my heart. There is no difference. I mean, Vrindavan is my heart. Now, Aradhya Bhagavan Vajajastanayastadhyama Vrindavan. I want to worship Nanda Nandan Sri Krishna. Aradhya Bhagavan Vrajo in Sanskrit, if you split up, Sandhi. Vrajo, Aradhya Bhagavan Vajajastanayam. Vrajo Yukta Isho. Vrajo Yukta Isho. Who is the king? Isho means? Ishwar, I mean king. Brajasa is Nanda Baba?
Nanda Baba.
So whom to worship? Aradhya Bhagavan Brajasa Stanaya. Nanda Maharaj, his son, is the only objective of my worship. Aradhya Bhagavan Brajasa Stanaya and Taddhama Vrindavana. And the dham in which he is playing all the time. That dham is also Taddhama Vrindavana. And how to worship? What is the procedure? What is the procedure? Those gopikas, they are showing the procedure. Ramma kachid upasana brajavadu vargena ja kalpita. Brajavadu vargena ja kalpita. The way shown already, there's brajagopikas, they are showing. That is the only way. That is the only and unique way you should follow, and 100% you can satisfy Krishna. Why Rupa Goswami was speaking this way? Anyabhilasita sunyam jnana karmadi anavritam anukullena krishnanusilanam bhakti ruttama. First, you should understand this sloka. But I am very sorry, I have no sufficient time to discuss all this point. I will have to bring this point, like mathematics. Then I can satisfy all the point. This is mathematical, no scientific. But I have no time, very short time. With short sketch, I will have to clarify this point, you see. Very important. So now you get the procedure, I mean, avida. First you get sambandha, In this sloka itself, Samanda Gan is there. Samanda and Avidya, how to? The Prajagopika, Son Bhai. This is Avidya, Samanda, Avidya, and Prajan, what you are going to get ultimately? Prema. That Prema is also not ordinary to you. So, Aradha Bhagavan Vajasana Saddhami Vindaman, Rama Kachidu Vesana Bhajavadu Garmenu Jakalpita. Srimad Bhagavatam Pramana Mamalam. Srimad Bhagavat is the topmost, I mean, darshan, scientific darshan of, for Gaudiya Bhakta. Very deep philosophy there. Srimad Bhagavatam Pramana Mamalam. I need not go through any scripture. If you can give me Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is complete for me. And Chaitanya Charitamrita or Srimad Bhagavatam, all the same. Same thing there, represented. I need not go through any philosophy. Only Chaitanya Charitamrita is more than sufficient to give me Nitya Seva. Srimad Bhagavatam Pramana Mamalam Prema Pumartho Mahano. As a big treasure, Bhagavatam can give you love. Bhagavatam, that's why I told 4 or 5 days, I think before, somebody can put question, who is the Gurudev of Parikshit Maharaj? They are fighting. Who is the Gurudev? From whom Guru Parikshit Maharaj took Diksha? We don't find any Gurudev? Prabhupada saying you are all foolish, idiot. What do you mean by Diksha? What do you mean by Diksha? Diksha means to develop Dibhagyan. Dibhagyan means deep dhatu and glowing. Deep dhatu means glowing. Very nice. And what is the Dibhagyan? You should develop Samandagyan. You should know how to follow the ultimate goal. That is called avidya. You are developing the knowledge of Sammanda. After that, avidya. After that, prayer. All there in Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam is equal to Kamgayatri. Bhagavatam is equal to all mantra. Nothing. No deficiency there, no scarcity. Bhagavatam is a complete thing. Krishna himself. Parikshit, Sukhdev Goswami is speaking. That Srimad Bhagavatam is no other than Krishna. Shakshat Sri Krishna Evahi. Sukhdev Goswami is speaking. What do you mean by Bhagavatam? Sukhdev Goswami is Sri Krishna Evahi. Krishna himself. In the form of transcendental sound vibration, Krishna himself. Himself, Krishna. And suppose Jiva Goswami is speaking, Krishna Parivartita. Krishna taking a unique form of Bhagavatam. Krishna Parivartita. Krishna changes like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is Krishna himself. Krishna is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sri Krishna Chaitanya. No. No different. But Krishna changes body color, mood, only this much. Taking the golden complexion of Radharani, get enveloped, try to hide himself inside Radha Baba, inside Radha Baba, inside Radha Baba, outside Radha complexion, and looking all the same Krishna. How to detect, how to arrest? Eh? How to arrest? So there you find Krishna Parivartita. And this Bhagavatam can give you everything. Everything. I mean Rupanuga, Raganuga Bhakti, all. Ultimately. Addo eva paro rasaha. Addo eva paro rasaha. I can discuss this point, not together. Ultimately, the original rasa is adirasa. Very deep philosophy. I like to discuss this point. But sorry, I don't have time now. Adya eva pararashaha. What do you mean, adya rashaha? From Chaitanya Charitamrita, from this sloka, I can tell you how you can understand. Very nice. Now, point is that Srimad Bhagavatam Pramanamamalam Primapumartama and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Matam Idam Tathagam. Mahaprabhu want to express his heart. What Mahaprabhu want to speak? All they are doing. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Matam Idam. That is the Siddhanta, that is the feeling of Mahaprabhu. Same as Bhagavatam. If you go through Bhagavatam and get the plainness, no difference. So now you get this clear picture, starting and in between and finally Vajra. Sambandha Vidyaya. So it is a syllabus. At a glance you can see, oh, this is, so I need to. Now you go to, what do you mean by Raganu Bhakti, I told you. Ishte sarasi ki ragaha paramavishtata bhavet tanmuya bhavet bhakti satru ragat mikodita. That is called Raganuga Bhakti. Whereas you are showing bhakti with rasa, not that dry love. There is no dry love. There is no opulences. You see opulences. If you see opulences, then you cannot, oh, big opulences there. Krishna is Supreme Lord. Then you cannot get rasa. Because rasa can come down. If you see, if you like to think that way, Krishna is Supreme Lord, oh, come on, Krishna is Supreme Lord, then you cannot enjoy that kind of secret rasa. Because your feeling is, your mind is just your... You are just hypnotized by the opulences. Now you cannot get the taste of that Raganuga Bhakti. Raganuga Bhakti in who is Krishna? Is some with me? Madhumangal, when taking prasadam with Madhumangal in one row, Krishna there, Madhumangal here. When Yasodama serving, Yasodama, Rohinima, then Madhumangal say, Mother, Krishna is actually sick. He cannot digest this kind of prasadam. You give me. Don't give me. I can. He is sick. He cannot digest. His digestion power is not good. Give me. Mother, don't give. This kind of feeling is sick. So nice feeling. So this is actually Raganuga Bhakti. Who are you? You and me same. Huh? You are my friend. This is called Raganuga Bhakti. Ishte sarasike ragaha paramavishtata bhave. And there should be one deep feeling. I mean, one kind of induction. Induction, you know? In Faraday's law, electricity. Induction, you see? Faraday's law. In childhood, in boyhood, we read Faraday's law. This. So you can, you can get electrical magnetic field. There you can see. So some kind of induction is there. Induction. So you can feel nothing there in my mind. Induction. Or intoxication, you can also say. Like after taking wine, where is this? What do you say? Like this. This kind of feeling you should have. Ishte sarasigiragaha paramavishtatabhavet tanmuya bhavet bhakti. Bhavet means vidilinga. It must be. But I mean to say, Rupa Goswami says, it must be like this. Bhavet means in Sanskrit. Bhavet means Sanskrit. In Sanskrit, there is a 100% fixed. The Siddhanta is fixed up. You cannot change it. Tanmuya bhavet bhakti sato ragat nibodhita. Now bhakti siddhanta, now I like to discuss so many points, but I have to go to Madhavendu Pribhat because otherwise I cannot get keeper. So I like to set one link. Madhavendra Puripada and Gauriya Bhajan. I like to show you the link. Directly, not that indirectly. Madhavendra Puripada. Today is the disappearance day of Madhavendra Puripada. So today is the appearance day of Madhavendra Puripada inside my heart. Don't feel that. Today is the disappearance day of Madhavendra Puripada. But today is the appearance day of Madhavendra Puripada inside my heart. That is the actual feelings of separation. If you at all like to feel a feeling of separation, should be positive, like what I am speaking to you. Follow. This is deep philosophy. No, common people cannot find any symmetry. What is the mercy? This way, that way? So this. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada speaking, the sloka by Madhavendra Puripada is the vitals of Gauriya Bhajan. Ai Dindaya Donadai Mathuranad Kadavalakasya Hidayam Tadulok Kastram Daita Brahmantya. Kim Karomi Aham. This sloka, very nice. Prabhupada speaking, this is the vitals of Gauriya Bhajan. Why? But because this is the feeling of Radharani. By chance, by the mercy of Radharani, this sloka came into the heart of Madhavendra Puripada, the last moment. When Madhavendra Puripada is going to leave his body, then automatically this sloka appears by the mercy of Radharani. It is this Siddhanta given by Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami Chaitanya Charitamrita. Originally this sloka is by Radharani, and by chance by the mercy of Radharani this sloka appeared in the tongue of, in the heart of Madhavendra Puripada. Very nice. Now, point is that what is the philosophy behind it? Why Madhavendra? Okay, if it is at all by Radharani, then why Mathuranath, why she is speaking? Or Madhavendra Puripada, why is speaking that way? Mathuranath, because he is loving Vrindavana Chandra, why Mathuranath, why speaking that way? Is there any reason why? Yes, very deep sentiment. Very deep sentiment here. That is called Raganuga Bhakti. Radharani crying. Radharani is speaking that way. Now you gone to Mathura. We are uneducated. We are not trained to satisfy you. We are not smart lady to satisfy you. There in Mathura is big city. There you can be so much educated woman, I mean gopi. They are educated, they know etiquette, how to satisfy you. So we are unfit to serve you. Maybe for this reason you leave me, they leave us. That is the reason I know. We cannot satisfy you. That's why you leave us. Now you are Mathuranath. We cannot speak you are Vrindavana Chandra because you leave us. There is one kind of, that is actually Raganuga Bhakti. Deep feeling. Raganuga Bhakti, very twisted, very deep feeling you should have. When I discuss about Jagadananda Pandit and Mahaprabhu's Leela, where you find? In Raganuga Bhakti, when actually when Jagadananda was speaking heavily with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who told you I bring oil from Bengal? I don't bring any oil. That means he is expressing deep love. But in material world, you see, if you have any altercation with somebody, after 1 minute he cannot see your face. He is coming. I cannot see his face because they develop some kind of hatred. They hate each other. But Raganuga Bhajan, come on, same thing. You see, who told you I bring? I don't bring any wealth from my life. But there is love. But in material world, after some altercation, fighting, I don't like to see your face. Go ahead. But in transcendental world, there you can see that maybe he is speaking that way. But he likes to do some seva to Mahaprabhu. That's why. He is very angry with Mahaprabhu. Why you don't accept this well? That's why for 3 days I am fasting. When Mahaprabhu, I am going to take prasadam in your hand. Can you cook? Yes, I can cook. That's why. Then all all problem finished. All problem finished. He was very angry. But all angry attitude gone. Prabhu going to take seva. So I am very happy. I was angry. Why? Prabhu didn't accept my seva. That is called Raganuga Bhakti. And material world, they can fight with each other. So nice philosophy. So now you see, Madhavendra Puri Bhad speaking that way. Now you are Mathuranath. Those educated ladies, they are trained. They can serve you. We are just unfit. This way he is expressing his deep feeling that, oh, we lost your seva. We Dindaranathi Mathuranath. Kadabalaka Sihidam Tadaloka Kataram. I am crying for you. If I cannot see you, I am going to die. I am going to die without seeing you. Can you save us? Can you appear here in Vrindavan and can give your darshan so that we can leave? That's the feeling. Actually, in Raganuga Bhajan, Rupanuga Bhajan, outside you can see there is feeling of separation there inside heart, but that separation can bring Krishna inside your heart to Milan. Viraha and Milan, where is deep Viraha, I mean feelings of separation there inside your heart, but there is also Krishna, you are meeting Krishna. You are crying, Krishna is not there. Really, Krishna is not there. Krishna is gone. But Krishna is there inside your heart. Deep feeling of separation means it can bring Krishna from there and put inside your heart, and you and Krishna, you can meet each other. Follow. So, viraha means milan. Viraha means milan. And even we see in the character of Radharani, when Krishna is there, just here, there is not even 1 inch different. See, Radharani, where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? Krishna is there standing in front of you. Even he, Krishna is there in your lap, embracing Krishna. Where is Krishna? I lost Krishna. It's deep feeling. Because in Milan, he is feeling separation. Milan is there itself. But still Krishna, oh, I lost Krishna. And Krishna is there in your lap, you embracing. But he feels, no, Krishna is not there. You cannot feel it. You have to go deep into bhajan, day by day. Then you can understand my feelings today, what I am speaking. You have to go to bhajan day after day, deep bhajan. Then you can feel what I wanted to say today. What I wanted to say. Now you see Madhavendra Puri Pad. We see Madhavendra Puri Pad is a pillar in your Gauriya Bhajan. Why you speak this way? Why don't you speak that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the pillar in our bhajan? Actually, Supreme Lord, Bhagavan Sri Krishna Chaitanya, he don't like to take that kind of patishtha. Sampradaya, anything, this kind of pratishtha, Krishna Bhagavan always give responsibility to one nice devotee. Krishna himself never acts that way. Sampradaya pravartan, to start a new sampradaya, it is the duty of Krishna, but not direct duty. Indirect duty. Krishna wants to get it done. Krishna wants to get it done by a unique devotee. I am his own associate. Krishna wants to do. Krishna wants to do. But Krishna wants to get it done by. Same thing. Krishna manifesting this lila of taking diksha from Bhaguri Muni. Krishna took diksha from Bhaguri Muni. Krishna learned all scripture from Sandipani Muni. Ramchandra get diksha from Ashtavakra Muni. Ramchandra got all siksha from Vishwamitra Muni. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu got all siksha from whom? Pandit from whom he learns many things, you see. Gangadas Pandit. Gangadas Pandit. Gangadas Pandit. And externally he manifests a lila of taking diksha from Isha Pripa. He took sannyas from Kesha Bharati. But is it true? Is it true? Mahaprabhu took sannyas from... No. When Achyutananda, the very small boy, playing there with other boys, when he heard somebody asking question to Advaita Gosai, who is the sannyas guru of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Actually, Keshav Bharati is the sannyas guru. Then the small boy coming in front of Advaita Gosai. Why? You are speaking that way? You are a big personality in spiritual figure, in spiritual line. You are speaking this way? Small boy. Then whole world, you actually, if you guide wrongly, it's not good. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Supreme Lord, who can be his guru? Then Advaita Gosai with loving mood, taking the boy in lap and kissing him. You are my guru, you are my guru, you are my guru. Actually, you are right, speaking rightly. But what to do? They are asking, I am bound to speak that way? I am bound to speak that way? So we see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu give sannyas mantra to Keshav Bharati and name. I got this name in dream. Sri Krishna Chaitanya, can you think about it? Is it Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? I got this name, my name, Sri Krishna Chaitanya. Do you think it fit? You think about it, then he gets this name. Because he is Krishna Chaitanya. Same thing. So very secret philosophy there. So Madhavendra Puripad is a, you see, pillar in Gauriya Bhajan line. That's why Prabhupada told the sloka by Madhavendra Puripad, Vai Dindyadunadi Maturanat Kadavarakashihiran Gagluku Kadram Daito Brahmatiham, Brahmantiham, Kim Karom, Kim Karomi Brahmantiham. What I can do? So this sloka is the vitals of Gauriya Bhajan. All Gauriya devotees, those who are having Raganuga Bhakti, I mean Rupanuga Bhakti, they should feel ultimately that way. Ultimate. Now come on, Madhavendra Puripad was manifesting Lila. I like to discuss some Siddhanta. Like yesterday I was also discussing, Madhavendra Puripad is the disciple of Lakshipati. Lakshipati. Actually, you can say that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's appearance is actually Gauranga Mahaprabhu already manifest into the heart of Madhavendra Puripad. Already. Somebody can say, how it was possible for Madhavendra Puripad to get that kind of feeling? How possible? Whereas Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in disciplic order, after one or two generations, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu manifests. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the original personality, I mean Supreme Lord, with whom the original treasure is there with Mother Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because if Chaitanya Mahaprabhu don't distribute, nobody can see. Now question is that, this kind of feeling, how is possible that Madhavendra Puripad got much before the appearance of Gauranga Mahaprabhu? How is that possible? Then our Tikagar, they're speaking, who say you this way? Actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already appeared in his heart. Before appearance here in the material world, before appearing in this material world, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already appeared into the heart of Madhavendra Puripad. Already. Because when Supreme Lord coming, you can find one thing very clear, like one minister going, very important, president going, then some car going, vigilance going, whistle, after that president coming, after that backside of big and a security forces going. So when Krishna appear, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appear, when Ramchandra Mahaprabhu Bhagavan appear, you can see the same thing. Before Krishna Bhagavan appearing, before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you can find he is sending or deputing all his paraphernalia. Go. Like Jagannath Misra, Advaita Gosai, Sachima, all the devotees, they are coming, Sivas Pandit, all they come. After Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gone, you can find Narottama Thakur, Srinivasa Acharya, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, they all coming. Actually, they are all personal associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But it seems they are appearing before, they are appearing after, they are appearing. It doesn't mean. Even Srinivasa Acharya externally could not get the chance to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Externally. Externally, Srinivasa could not meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Narottama Thakur could not meet. Narottama Thakur could meet, actually. Narottama Thakur did parikrama under the guidance of who? Under the guidance. And under the guidance of Ishan Thakur, the servant of Chaitanya, homely servant. Ishan Thakur, by the mercy of Ishan Thakur, Srinivasa Acharya did parikrama. Under the guidance of Srinivasa. So nice. So now you see, Madhavendra Puripad is a pillar of Gauriya Bhajan. So I give you touch. What is the feeling of Madhavendra Puripad? Now, from Madhavendra Puripad we get Ishar Puripad getting the same kippa. The whole heart of Madhavendra Puripad and the feelings of Madhavendra Puripad was transferred into the heart of Ishar Puripad. Through seva. Without seva, if you go through philosophy, you can go to market, you can buy so much books. Green banana can be given to you. Buy green banana. You have to do seva from heart. If you can have the chance to serve a pure Vaishnava, from heart you will have to do. Otherwise, you cannot get. Panipatena paribhashana sevaya upadikshanti to jnanam jnanina stattarasina. That is the procedure. If you break this procedure, even not at all successful. You cannot come out successful. If you break this procedure, remember, from heart you will have to do seva. Otherwise you cannot get. That feeling that is there inside the heart of your Gurudev cannot be transferred to you. Like lightning, I told you, Bhaktivinoda Thakur said, like lightning, one cloud coming in contact with another cloud, then immediately some exchange of a free ion take place, free iron take place, then at a goom, you can sound. One sound. After that, lightning, cha, electricity. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur was speaking there. This is one kind of disease. If my Gurudev have this kind of disease of Krishna prema, that disease I can also get. That is disease, you see, contagious disease. If you come in contact with that man who is having that kind of disease, you can also develop. You can also develop that kind of disease. No other way. No other way. You see. So now Madhavendra Puri, you see, I like to speak something about the seva done by Madhavendra Puri, the feeling of Radha and Madhavendra Puri. I like to discuss something very clear, Leela. Madhavendra Puri, some special issue, outside people can fight. Outside people saying, we see Sam Baba is Niskinchan. Why he making library? Why he making Gosala? Why he making this? He need not do it. He can sit and do bhajan. They understand anything about bhajan? They understand? When Prabhupada making 64 temples all over the world, then people finding with him. He can go to a solitary place and do Harinam. What do you mean by bhajan? Somebody is speaking, Prabhupada already makes 64 temples all over. Actually, 64 temples is nothing. I wanted to install Gauriya Math inside the heart of each and everybody. You say I make 64 temples? 64 temples? But those foolish people, idiot, they are demon. They fight. Ishwar Puripad, Madhavendra Puripad, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they all Niskinchan, topmost Niskinchan. Madhavendra Puripad, like Sukhdev Goswami, never asks anything from anybody. By chance, by the mercy of Krishna, if somebody bring milk in front of him, Godugdha, Gorosh, not buffalo milk. If by the chance, by Krishna sending some milk in front of Madhavendra Puripad, then he can accept it. Otherwise not. Follow my point. Only milk. No bread, nothing, no sabji, nothing. Only milk. Yeah, that even if he automatically if somebody bring, then otherwise not. In Chaitanya Charitamrita is written, Namanande Tipto. Namanande Tipto. Madhavendra Puripad is always satisfied by Harinam. There is no appetite, there is no thirstiness, nothing there. No agitation, always satisfaction, saturation. Always deep saturation there, existing into the heart of Madhavendra Puripad. He never feel thirsty. He never feel hungry, never. He never feel angry. He never feel hungry. Never. Why? Always satisfied. He is always satisfied. No kind of dissatisfaction can touch the heart of Madhavendra Puripad. Now that Madhavendra Puripad now going to Govardhan and sitting evening time, sitting just beside Govardhan, after doing circumambulance, I mean parikram, after doing parikrama Govardhan, he is sitting just beside Govindakund, sitting there under a tree, and he is doing Harinam. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram. He is looking Krishna. He can see all the leela of Krishna through Nam, because Nam is a seed. Nam is a seed of all leela. Like Batabiksha banyan tree, if you see, go to the history of banyan tree, you can see one small seed is there. Even you can see, you cannot see properly, it's a small seed. Poppy seed, you know, poppy seed, any seed, poppy seed. even very small, not mustard seed, 1/10 division. That seed, that you see, is sufficient to give birth to a banyan tree. Now after 500 years, 1000 years, 2000 years, 5000 years, the trees take the form. Oh, big tree. In botanical garden there in Calcutta, you can go, you cannot trace out what is the original root of that banyan tree. If you go to Naimisharana, you cannot find out the root of that banyan tree. Where is the root? Eh? Cannot find. Why? Whereas the possibility of birth of that banyan tree was there inside that seed. Follow. Possibility was there inside the seed. And that fruit, I mean one small kind of fruit is there in banyan tree. One bird taking it. Aja, Guru Bhai, aja. Bye, Tom. After, hey.
Kapoor.
So, under banyan tree, see. Hey. That asunda. A special asunda. He is my godfather, senior godfather. Yes. So by chance you see that seed, first of all you can find one bird taking the fruit. After that bird passing stool, when that bird after taking the fruit, that bird when passing stool, and that stool, if it is somehow, if you get in contact with air, water, and light. If it is somehow, then the possibility of that banyan tree can express automatically. You can find that some old houses there, broken, dilapidated condition. There you can find, after 200 years, 500 years, you can find a big banyan tree there developed. But ultimately, that possibility was there, lying with that seed, small. So you see what I say? You mean to see? So Madhavendra Puripad now today, is when going into Govardhan, there, after circumambulance, after doing parikram of Giriraj Sila, Giriraj Govardhan, he's just sitting in front of Govinda Kundo and under a tree, and chanting all the time, because he is always satisfied, he is always saturated, no kind of dissatisfaction is there with Madhavendra Puripad. Now what I mean to say, because Harinam is the seed of everything. All Leela you can see, all Parafarnalia, all Dhamma, Nama, even you can see everything. You can see everything. If you can do Harinam properly by the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And the same sloka I told you, Radha Govinda can manifest inside your heart, provided your Harinam is perfect and provided you are following Rupanuga Bhakta, then you can see Radha Govinda there inside. Yatha yatha gaura padar vinde vinde yata bhaktim kitapunna rasi tatha tatha utsarpatiti hidya kasmal radha padambuja sudhamburasi. Now I already solved this problem. Somebody can say, we Gauriya, we must do bhajan under the guidance of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is, when Madhavendra Puripad doing bhajan, we don't see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But those Tikakar, those who are giving commentary, they're speaking that way. That Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already manifest into the heart of Madhavendra Puripad. Though you externally you can find some gapping, that Madhavendra Puripad manifests before, and Gauranga Mahaprabhu. There's gapping, you can mathematically, theoretically, mathematically you can find. But there is no fighting in it. That Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already manifested from. Now Madhavendra Puripa is sitting there, he is satisfied. Now all of a sudden, he finds one young boy, very nice, coming in front of him with a pot full of milk and offering him and speaking, Puripa, what you are thinking about? I think you are in meditation. What kind of meditation? What kind of meditation? Always we see that you are in deep meditation. That boy asking, always we find you are always in deep meditation. What kind of meditation you are performing? And why you are not asking prasadam from Brajavasis? Why? It is the usual rule. Those who are not asking anything from anybody, it is my responsibility. I directly go there and give prasadam to them. Yes! I can show you so many examples. When Radharani, yes, Radharani directly coming to give prasadam. Sometimes sending Lolita, oh Lolita, go and give prasadam to him. In Nandagram, in many places, I can show you this kind of example. Krishna speaking, sometimes if somebody not asking any prasadam from anybody, it is my responsibility, I go. Even then, Madhavendra Purvat could not understand who is he. Because Jogamaya. Because Madhavendra Puripad now looking Krishna, he cannot understand because he is just hypnotized by this man. But Jogamaya can put a magic spell on you. Like Krishna Bhagavan when manifesting childhood Leela, when Putana came, now in Chaitanya Chaitamita is written, Jaha Krishna Taha Nahi Maya Radhika. I got it. Come on. In Chaitanya Chaitamita we find, Yaha Krishna Taha Nahi Maya Radhika. Putana is Maya. Putana is Maya. Then how Putana got the chance to come in contact with Krishna? Now question coming. During Bhagavad discourse, I can discuss this point, all in clear. Now I touch. Here is two kind of Maya, one is Yogamaya, one is Mahamaya. Those who are not devotees, those who are Asura, they are just hypnotized by Mahamaya. And the Yashoda Ma, Rohini Ma, they are just hypnotized by Mahamaya, Yogamaya. बाद में आपका साथ देखा होगा गुरु भाई बातें हैं ठीक जय गुरु ठीक सो दिस काइंड ऑफ फीलिंग यू सी जोगमाया महामाया सो हियर माधवेंद्र पुरीपाद इज जस्ट इन तत्व संदर्भ वेरी सीक्रेट फिलोसॉफी देयर यू कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड यू हैव टू फॉलो वन प्योर वैष्णव दे कैन एक्सप्लेन दैट जीव गोस्वामी दे आर गिविंग एग्जांपल that so many Shakti, countless Shakti working from Krishna. Main Shakti is Radharani, but countless Shakti working. Out of that, one Shakti is there, Shab Prakashata Shakti. Jiva Goswami is speaking, Shab Prakashata Shakti. You follow my thought. Radharani is the original Shakti, okay. But ultimately there is countless Shakti working in favor of Krishna. Sometimes positively, sometimes negatively, according to the desire of Krishna. Now, Jiva Goswami was speaking, one special type of Shakti is there. What is that Shakti? Krishner Shaprakashata Shakti. Suppose, we don't know, if suppose Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is standing here. Suppose, because Bhagavan Sri Krishna already coming. Mad Bhakta Jatra Gayanti Tattva Tishtami Bharata. When my devotee is there singing, be sure I am present there. Maybe I am not devotee. Maybe you are all devotee. Maybe to test you, Krishna's Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is standing there, but nobody can see. Follow me, what I say. Because Krishna Bhagavan already commitment there. Madhavto yatra gayanti tatto tishtami. Tishtami. Where you find my all devotees are singing Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Ah, wherever you find devotees, they are singing, Krishna give commitment, be sure I am present. So suppose Krishna present here, Chaitanya, who can tell? But we cannot see. So Krishna can reserve the right of not being exposed to your sense organ. Krishna can reserve the full right of not being exposed to your sense organ. Those who are pure devotees, they can reserve the full right of not being exposed to your sense organ. They can act like mad. Oh, he is madman. Let us go. We cannot waste our time. Crazy. It's not crazy. He's showing that so that people cannot disturb me. Go, go, go. I can do Harinam. Quality and quantity cannot persist together. If you go for quantity, you cannot get quality. And if you go for quality, you cannot get together, you cannot get. So now you see, what I speak is Madhavendra Puripad now by Jogomaya. By Jogomaya. So Krishna standing here, maybe you cannot see. So Jiva Goswami is speaking, Krishna's Svaprakashata Shakti. What is called in Sanskrit? Krishna's Svaprakashata Shakti. Krishnasya Svaprakash. Prakasa Manasya Saptihi. Krishnasya in Sanskrit. Krishner Svaprakasa. Krishna have one kind of sakti by which Krishna can manifest his transcendental feature in front of you. If he at all want to express. If he at all Krishna is interested to manifest his own transcendental feature in front of you, Krishna can do it. Like one, I can give example, nice example. If we go back to Nilachal, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Lila, at the time of Ratha Yatra, you can find there seven sampradaya, seven different groups. They are playing mridanga at the time, so nice playing mridanga. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu dancing. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu dancing in front of Jagannath. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu dancing. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu dancing. But nobody can see that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is dancing in seven different groups. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu dancing in one group, I can see. No. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu dancing in seven different groups, simultaneously. What do you say? Yes. Yes. Only 1 or 2% devotees could see it. Nobody could see. Raja Pratapruddho, Samavartacharya and 1 or 2%. They can see. Why? Mahaprabhu, we can see Mahaprabhu in seven different sampradayas. Simultaneously Mahaprabhu crying and dancing, but nobody can see because Krishna wants to give darshan to them only. Krishna can reserve the right of not being exposed to your sense organ. So you see the excellency, what nice. Krishna is there, but nobody can see. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is there, nobody can see. So Madhavendra Puripad can see Krishna in front of him. Why you don't ask anything from anybody? You are hungry? Why you know? How you know I am hungry? Actually, how I can know? Those Brajamaya, those mother, Brajamaya, the Brajagopi, they come here in Govinda Kundo. For the long time they are looking that you are sitting, not asking anything they thought that you are hungry, so they give milk to me and order me to give it to you. That's why you come. How I know? I cannot know. The Brajamaya, the Brajavas, the Brajagopis, they order me. My son, you can go. Take the trouble to give this pot to that sannyasis. He is sitting there for long and only chanting and chanting, nothing, asking nothing. Maybe he is hungry. Hungry. You can go. That's why I come. Oh, really? Oh, really? Oh, you can drink milk, and after that I can come and take that pot. First to drink. Huh? I can come later. Then the boy gone. After taking milk, Madhavamba become mad. What kind of testing? What kind of test I get inside this? I took milk many times in my life. Countless time I took milk. But what is this? Is milk or amrita? Is this milk or amrita nectar? What kind of feeling now I get out of this milk? Oh my God! After taking milk, drinking milk, now he is sitting, evening time over. Now gradually Madhavendra Purva feeling some fatigueness. I mean, so a little tired. He expressing this little. Now after that in dream, that boy is not coming, because Madhavendra Purva is, when that boy can come? It's a long time over, that boy not coming, but now night. Then in the meantime he feels sleepy. As if in dream he see Krishna coming. Oh, I already come in front of you, give milk to you. I am Krishna, Gopal, Govardhan Dadi. I am there inside this forest of Govardhan. Can you take me out of Govardhan, a forest, and install my seva there? Because I am looking for a long time when Madhavendra Purva can come and give me seva. Kobe Madhavasi Mor Koribe Shevan in Bengali Chaitanya. For long time I am looking. For long time I am looking and waiting. When Madhavendra Purva can come and give me seva, do my seva, I am waiting. Now I am successful, you come in front of me. Can you take the trouble to take me out of that forest? Then Madhavendra Purva get up and crying like crazy, oh God, Krishna, you came in front of me. You cheat me, I couldn't understand you. There was some catchy feeling. There was some catchy feeling, but still I couldn't. Some magnetic feeling I felt. When that boy came, what is that boy? So nice. I couldn't catch that you are Krishna. Oh, you are. You cheat me, oh Krishna. I get Krishna, I miss Krishna. He's crying. Then after that, to carry out the order of Madhavendra Guripad, to carry out the order of Krishna, Madhavendra Guripad, now keeping patience with him. Okay. If I am not steady now, how I can do this seva ordered by Krishna? Then morning time he go to village. Oh, Prajavasis, you all come, come, come. In night time, Krishna came in dream with me. In my dream, Krishna came. In my dream, and I saw Krishna. Krishna giving order inside this forest. Govardhan there. Govardhan Dari Krishna. Govardhan Dari Krishna is there. And that deity was installed by Vajranava. By Vajranava. Then Brajavasis also. What you say, Baba? What you say, Baba? They speak Baba to me also. All Brajamaya Mataji there. Baba, why you don't come to me to take prasadam? Last day, we keep paramana everything for you. I say, Ma, excuse me, mother. That mother ordered me, don't go anywhere. Today I can give prasadam. That's why I couldn't. Because I am their servant. Those Matajis, they think I am their child. So if they chide me, don't go anywhere today. I can give prasadam. Okay. This way I was there. I was bound to stop. So you see, this way, actually it was installed by Vajranava. Those Vajvasis speaking, Baba, let us go there. Baba, let us go there. Where the forest is? Well, actually I saw in dream, maybe I can remember this way. Madhavendra was thinking, actually I saw a dream, the way to go into that forest. But I think this way. But I cannot remember properly, maybe this way. So let us go. With all hacksaw, everything. They take. Go inside. They go inside forest. Oh, they find one deity there, full of mud and clay. Clay, actually. Oh, that is deity. After that, all Brajavasis, big Brajavasis, they are taking milk, 2 liter, 3 liter at a time. So so powerful they are. That also buffalo milk they take. They took Krishna in their lap, many people, Brajavasis. Then they take Krishna, go come outside. After that, as per the order of Krishna, I mean, they take the deity, a top hill. I mean, Govardhan Tophi. There they establish. There is no singhasan, there is no thorn, but still with stone and this, that, Madhavendra make nice thorn, you see. Temporary stone. Establish Krishna there. Now the question of Abhishek Kami. First of all, Amangala, Amangala, Durikaran. It is Sanskrit. First of all, preliminary, first of all you have to put water and clean the deity. After that, with new cloth, Madhavendra put that deity, then started, Abhishek started. Govinda Govinda water, so many hundreds of pot pitcher there, all Brajamaya, Brajavasi they are going, getting water from the pond, I mean Govinda Kunda, and after purifying, I mean with cloth, they purify. After that, they are putting in front of Madhavendra Puripad so that Madhavendra Puripad can do nice Abhishek. Big Abhishek was done. Now Krishna is very satisfied. Madhavendra Puripad give order to those Brajavasi, Gujavasi, and they started cooking. They started puri, sabji, different kind of sweets and paramanna. They prepare very. All Brajavasi, hundreds of people, they're cooking. There's a big feast. Big feast going on. Thousands of people can come from different places. They can have the chance to take prasadam and look Krishna. Look, Krishna manifests. He is our Govardhan Dari. He manifests himself in front of us. Now that Govardhan Dari gone to where? Gujarat. Now he is going to Gujarat. Where? Nathodwar. One place is there, Nathodwar. There Krishna Guha. How? Big history there. I don't like to discuss this one. I can discuss this. Being to Memlecha attack, somehow Krishna took the travel. Purposely Krishna went there. First of all, he went to Vitthalnath house, the son of Vallabhacharya. Rupa Goswami Pad or all devotees, they got the chance to see Krishna in Mathura 1 month continuously, daily. Rupa Goswami Pad, full troops, they are coming, dancing, kirtan, speaking Harikatha, Vitthalnath house in Mathura. And there is big history I can speak after, not this is not the time. Now after that, cooking is over. After that, cooking is over, always cooking going on. No cooking over. They offer to Krishna big amount, like hill. Anna, rice, like hills. They cook rice and throw on big. That is why we call Annakut. Annakut. Why you call Annakut? Anna means rice. Kut mean hill. Anna mean Anna, rice, and Kut mean hills. They are offering so much rice and chapati, sabji to Krishna, that it looks a hill. after that, Madhavendra Puripad can see. Madhavendra watching. Krishna is very hungry. For a long time, Krishna is fasting. Now, Madhavendra Prabhupada can see Krishna taking all sabji and chapati, and taking all sabji, chapati, paramanda, taking. Nobody can see. Only Madhavendra Prabhupada can see after worshipping. Oh, he is so hungry. So hungry. Krishna speaking. Nobody can see. After Krishna taking so many prasadam, after anything more, you can offer to me. Still after that, nobody can see that Krishna eat up all prasadam. Full prasadam is there. Though Krishna take all prasadam, but still, as it is there. Why? In Upanishad, Isha Upanishad, you can find Purna Sapurna Madayo Purna Meva Avasishvate. Purna Sapurna Madayo Purna Meva Avasishvate. What does it mean? It means, if it is infinity, Purna, if you take Purna out of it, still Purna is residue. So Krishna is complete, Krishna is Supreme Lord. Though Krishna is taking all prasadam, still he touched prasadam, so prasadam is as it is. That's why we have the scope to take prasadam. Otherwise, who is going to offer to Krishna if Krishna takes all prasadam? what we can eat? You are taking all prasadam daily. Who can cook for you? That's why King Krishna keep prasadam for us. We have the chance to take prasadam. Now, Madhavendra Prabhupada, after worshipping, doing all teva, Madhavendra Prabhupada only taking cow milk, nothing. Only charanamita, after the cow milk, prasadam, nothing. So, puri, sabji, everything for other devotee. Madhavendra Prabhupada took only milk. After that, all were news going on. Because news always going like wind, you see. Hey, Krishna manifests himself, Govardhan Dari, from different villages. All people coming every day, feast going on, big annakut going on every day. After some day, Krishna came in dream. Krishna speaking, Madhavendu, you are doing so much seva. My burning feeling is there in my body. Because so long I was put it into air and I'm in sunlight, so burning feeling. Can you take the trouble to go to South India, my soul? I mean, get pure chandan from there, so that you can apply in my body. I can feel cool. The burning film can go cool. Can you do it? Oh yes. He caused in dream. He saw Krishna. Then immediately, Madhavendra make two disciples. They are going from Bangla. They are Brahman, very pure family. Madhavendra giving diksha to them and give them responsibility to serve Gopal Sinaji. But Krishna ordered me, so I must go now. I cannot engage anybody. Krishna saying, you will have to go. Otherwise, if you send somebody, I am not going to get going to accept this seva. Oh, I can go myself. In old age, Madhavendra were coming long way. After that, coming to Balasar, Remuna. There, Madhavendra Prabhupada in. Then many incidents happen. You see, Madhavendra Prabhupada dancing there, singing. And after that, he thought, my Gopal is there in Govardhan. So if I know, because night time, they offer Kira Bhoga, special. Kira Bhoga. Madhavendra Prabhupada thought, actually, I don't know the taste of that Kira they offer. Those devotees, they are offering Kira night time. 12 pot of Kira, special Kira. See, if I can have the chance to test it, then I can go to Govardhan and offer accordingly. After that, Madhavendra was thinking, oh my God, how I think that way, I am very greedy. I should not speak that way. I want to take the taste of Kira. Huh? Chi. Then Madhavendra Prabhupada, without speaking anything, going to forest, I mean nearby, and one hut market is there, nighttime forest, daytime hut, daytime market, nighttime forest, because all jackal, everything coming and running there. So he's sitting on there in heart and chanting Harinam. Then after that, Pujari close that window. But night time, temple closed. Pujari going and taking rest. Night time, Krishna came. Hey, Pujari, get up. Who? Krishna. Open the window of the temple. Open the window of the temple. Why? I put one kira, you couldn't see it. Under my cloth, I keep one kira for one sannyasi. He is waiting there in a market. You will have to go there and give this kira for, to him. And Pujari become very frightened. Go and open the temple, take bath and open the temple. Really, find one kira there. Cloth was there. He put one. Krishna is very clever. He put one cloth up so that nobody can see that kira is there. Collect that kira and Krishna, excuse me, I made mistake. After that, with kira, he's going outside and calling. Listen to me, who is Madhavendra Puri? Who is that devotee, excellent devotee? Please identify himself, yourself. Because Krishna keep one kira for you. You must identify yourself. Then Madhavendra Puri Bhagavad is very sorry mood. Me, Madhavendra Puri. Oh, you are lucky. For you, Krishna keep kira for you. Oh, I like you take the dust food from your lotus. Don't do that. I am not devotee actually. Krishna keeps kira to me. It is causeless mercy. Krishna can do anything, but that doesn't mean, that cannot prove that I am devotee. Madhavendra took that kira and taking kira is taking and shedding tears. Oh Krishna, why you take the trouble to keep kira for me? I am a greedy personality, huh? That's why you could understand that I want kira. After crying, after kira prasadam taking, he keep the pot, mud pot, big pot. He crush that pot and put small pieces of pot. Every day Madhavendra Puri Bhagavat take this pot, I mean piece of mud pot, test. He get prema. Oh, Krishna give me kira. Every day. Now, in the morning time, he thought after kira is, after taking prasadam, Madhavendra Puri Bhagavat says, look, morning time, all people can know Krishna giving kripa to me. All people can come, run to me and pay dandava to me. It is good. Night time I must fly. Night time I should leave this place. But morning time they can come and give patishtha to me. Give garland and wash my leg. Oh my God, I must fly. Night time Madhavendra Puri Bhagavat fly. Nobody can see. Where is the devotee? Night time we saw him here. No, he gone. But still it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Patishtar Sabhav E Jaina Chahe Tarhai Vidhata Nirmito. So now is the time of Paran. You already did Paran? You must do. Actually, otherwise you can. So I am very sorry, I like to discuss, but no time cannot permit. Actually some devotee waiting for me also. I can discuss some point also tomorrow. I can, because today you are hungry, I think. You will have to take prasaija. So, excuse me, I like to stop today now. Vancha kalpadurvasik pasindh bevacha patitanang pavane bevishnabhyo. Because paran everybody should do now. Otherwise you can break. Any question?
Hey. What does it mean that Chachudan Divache Janagani Prabhu say? What does it mean that Guru is my eternal master? Because in one life I take, for example, picture from one, in another from second, and so on until I get perfection.
Chakshudan means Dibhagyan. Actually, you should not feel that way. I already give answer. Guru Tattva is Akhanda Tattva. You cannot speak that way. this was my guru previous life, you cannot speak that way. Because Janma Janma Prabhu say, Nityananda Prabhu's guru. So it's true. I can confess or I cannot confess. But Nityananda Balaram is guru. Give prasadam to them. And let us go. Prabhu, take prasadam. Prabhu.
And when in spiritual world, jiva who gets sadhana siddha jiva gets perfection, still there is some kind of senior, like senior gopi, and in the biography of guru Vaishnava, different Vaishnavas, we can see, like for example, this Srinivasacharya and
Dhuye chato.
Rama.
Dhuye bole shilam ami. Dhuye offer korte bole shilam. Ami alle bole dilam tomake dhuye Shivji ke debe. Anyway, give, no problem.
So, still there is some senior, eternal senior who are you?
Actually, look, you see. Externally, it
seems
he is senior to him.
Huh?
But externally, it seems. Vrindavanda, like one example I see. Vrindavanda Thakur speaking. Kishnadas Kaviraj Goswami speaking that Vrindavanda, I am just following Vrindavanda. Kishnadas Kaviraj Goswami speaking in every step in Chaitanya Charitamrita. I have no capacity to express, only I like to digest the feelings of Vrindavanda Thakur, then I can get power. Chaitanya Charitamrita you can give. Every time Kishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is telling, by the blessing of Vrindavanda Thakur. Now question is there, Vrindavanda Thakur is a Kusumapira Sakha. Kusumapira Sakha. I mean friend of Krishna. Whereas Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, he is a Manjari. Kasturi Manjari. Rupa Goswami, Sanatan Goswami, Lavanga Manjari. Rupa Goswami has Rupa Manjari. So what does it mean? What does it mean? That Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is inferior to Vrindavanda Thakur? What does it mean? Actually, eternally they are there in Vrajadam. According to Rasa Tattva, according to the Seva, they are there. All of them, they have some personal excellence. Sakarasa have some excellence itself. Madhura Rasa can have that kind of special excellence they can have. We cannot say Madhura Rasa is excellent. Oh, you are idiot, foolish. They are fighting among Vrindavan. They are fighting. Why they fight? It is written in Chaitanya, all Rasa excellent according to their own level. But if you are neutral, then Adi Rasa, Adya Eva Para Rasa, I can discuss this point. I can show you. So neutrally, if you judgment that Adi Rasa is most important and original rasa, from there all rasa come. I can show you.
Is that also Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur used the term, how he said?
So anyway,
Gadgada Samskara. Gadgada Samskara. Something in Jaiva Dharma.
And Jaiva Dharma.
Gadgada Samskara. You know this term?
You must speak clearly, otherwise your pronunciation I cannot. You must read it and tomorrow you can say. Now I am going actually, some devotee waiting for you. Okay, ma. You must digest. You must digest, otherwise I am giving blood for you. So you must digest it, what I am speaking. So one day you can discover you are big Siddhantavid. Big Siddhantavid you can find, one by one. All over the world we can send all Siddhantavid different places. They can cut opposite Siddhanta. That is my secret seva. Yes, follow?